March of 2010, my client here, Jacob Szafranski, was dating Karla Dunston, and on March 17th of 2010, she unfortunately was diagnosed with cancer. And on March 24th of 2010, she met with an oncologist to discuss her treatment options, and one of the things that was discussed was the possibility the chemotherapy could result in her becoming infertile. So on that day, March 24th, she contacted Jacob and asked him if he would be willing to donate sperm to be fertilized with her eggs so that they could then be frozen so that she could use them in the future after she recovered from her treatment. Jacob agreed to this, and then on March 25th, they went to a fertility clinic to have the procedure discussed in more detail. At that time, they signed a consent form that said the consent of both my client Jacob and Ms. Dunston was necessary in order for the fertility clinic to release the embryos. They then proceeded to have a meeting with an attorney at the suggestion of the fertility clinic to discuss in greater detail what to do with the embryos in the event the relationship changed. Ms. Dunston alleges that that document, which gives her control of the embryos in the event they break up, was an agreement that they actually reached at the meeting on March 25th or sometime later that day. My client Jacob denies that occurred, and the attorney who was present at this meeting testified in her deposition that this was more talking points than any firm agreement on what to do. Ms. Dunston then later began her chemotherapy treatments. Sometime after that, Mr. Szafranski ended the relationship, and then it got to the point where once Ms. Dunston recovered, she wanted to use the embryos to have a biological child. Jacob's life situation had changed, and he no longer wanted her to use them, and that's how this litigation began.
You know, we did have a discussion about potentially me being the donor to half of the embryos and then Carly going with a third-party anonymous donor, and it was something that we had talked about early on and continued to have discussions about, just to, you know, give us both those options if anything were to change or happen. And you know, at the time when the decision was made, I felt comfortable because I felt the contract that we had signed over a week ago expressed that my consent was needed in order for those embryos to be used in any capacity. And when she asked me to be the donor for these embryos, the other half, I had no objections to that, because I still felt that my ultimate say in the matter was still very much, you know, intact. And, you know, it's unfortunate how it all came about, but, you know, there were many discussions that were had leading up to that point, but I do know that, you know, that my co-consent form that I had signed kind of best represented what was going through both of our minds at the time.